Hello, welcome to the session of electronics. Myself Shyam Gore. Today we are discussing about the frequency spectrum of frequency modulation. In frequency modulation, after modulation, we observe the different types of the frequencies in the frequency modulated carrier wave, and that can be obtained by using the frequency spectrum, by observing the frequency spectrum of FM wave. So let us find out how many frequencies are present in the frequency modulated carrier wave. In frequency modulation, the mathematical representation for frequency modulation is like this. This is the mathematical equation for frequency modulated carrier wave. And if you are observing this equation, then this equation is EFM is equal to A sin omega CT plus MF sin omega MT. And this equation is very complex equation, or this equation is very difficult to simplify. And for the simplification of this equation, we are using the Bessel function, because here in this equation there is sine of sine, and for the expansion of this equation we are using the Bessel function. So when we use the Bessel function, according to the Bessel function, this equation is expand like this, that E FM is equal to A into bracket J0 MF sin omega CT plus J1 MF sin omega C plus omega M into T minus sin omega C minus omega M into T plus J2 MF sin omega C plus 2 omega M T plus sin omega C minus 2 omega M T plus J into MF sin omega C plus 3 omega M T minus sin omega C minus 3 omega M T plus J M F sin omega C plus 4 omega M into T plus sin omega C minus 4 omega M into T plus this equation is expand up to the infinity, J4, J5, J6, J7 up to the Jn. In this way, this equation is expand. Okay. Now, from this equation, if you are looking towards this equation, we can draw some conclusions. That conclusions are like this. The FM wave consists of the carrier. If you are looking toward this equation, or this is the equation, that is the J0 MF sin omega CT. Here the frequency is the omega CT, and omega CT is the frequency of the carrier wave. And therefore, this term is the equation for the carrier wave. Therefore, we can say that after frequency modulation, it contains the carrier wave. Okay. Similarly, another observation is that it has the so many sidebands. This is the first sideband, that is the omega C plus omega M. On other side, that is the omega C minus omega M. Next sideband is omega C plus 2 omega M. On other side, omega C minus 2 omega M. In this way, there are the number of sidebands, or we can say that in frequency modulation, the infinite number of sidebands are present. Okay, and side bands only do not present in the first term, that is the first term is for the carrier board, and after that there are the number of side bands or infinite side bands are present in the frequency modulation. So this is the frequency modulation, and the amplitude of carrier and side bands depends upon the J coefficient. Here amplitude and frequencies depends upon this coefficient, that is the J. Okay. So another important conclusions are, as the value of J coefficient are depend on the modulation index MF, the modulation index determine how many sideband components have significant amplitude, which is shown in this figure. Here, if you are looking towards this figure, the amplitude is decreases with the sideband. This is the carrier wave, this is the first order, this is the second order, third order, fourth order. In this way, the sideband, when the sidebands increases, its amplitude decreases. Okay, and amplitude is very decreases, and the practical bandwidth for the frequency modulated carrier wave is actually, theoretically we can say that the sidebands are infinite, therefore bandwidth for the frequency modulation is also the infinite, but practically it is calculated based on how many sidebands have significant amplitude. As you seen that the amplitude is decreases, okay, therefore the amplitude, when the amplitude is decreases, the sidebands or the bandwidth is calculated with the help of the sidebands. And in order to find the practical bandwidth, we are using the Thumb's rule or Carson's rule, and it is used to state the bandwidth of frequency modulated carrier wave. And for the frequency modulated carrier wave, the bandwidth is equal to the twice sum of frequency deviation and the highest modulation frequency. Therefore, for the FM wave, practical bandwidth is given by BW, and that is equal to 2 times delta plus FM max. Here delta is the frequency deviation and FM is the maximum modulating frequency. So the bandwidth is equal to the 2 times frequency deviation plus maximum modulating frequency. This is the bandwidth for frequency modulated carrier wave. And here let us hear. These are the sidebands on left hand side of the carrier wave, and on the right hand side of the carrier wave there are the number of sidebands, and the amplitude of that sidebands are decreases when we are going away from the carrier wave. Carrier wave have maximum amplitude. Okay, so this is the bandwidth of frequency modulated carrier wave. Or this is the frequency spectrum of frequency modulated carrier wave. Number of frequencies are present in the frequency modulated carrier wave, but the useful frequencies are very small or the less. So the bandwidth is equal to 2 times delta plus FM. Thank you for watching this video.